Everybody, welcome back to Cooking with the Riz. I'm Mark Rizzio at your service. Here today, we're going to make some banana pancakes for you. Yum, yum, yummy, yum. This is very lick your lip stuff. And so for today, it's quite simple. Very, very easy. I've got self-raising flour. I'm going to sift that with some bicarb. I've got some sugar, a couple of eggs, vanilla extract. Don't use vanilla essence in it. You want extract or vanilla beans. Even better. I've got a little bit of butter I'm going to put in here. I'm going to brown some butter off, and that's going to go in the mix as well. And some buttermilk. Use buttermilk, not normal milk. And then when I make the banana sauce, so obviously I've got bananas, I've got some butter, some sugar, and some cream. And that's it. So without further ado, let's rock this on. Okay, so I've got this self-raising flour here, which I'm going to spoon into here, because otherwise I'll make a bloody mess. Just sift this in because you want it to be nice and light. All right, you can just do that. You can add a bit of the bicarb in with this lot as well if you want to. So you can just tap it in. I've got 2 cups of flour here, but I'm not going to use that much, I don't think. We'll see. I'll go with, because you can always add, but you can't take out. So I'll just go with probably that there for now. And where's the rest of that bicarb? I've got about 2 to 3 teaspoons of bicarb here. You just want to just get that right in there like so. All right, so you got that in there like that. Just make a bit of a well in the center. You can drop your eggs in there. So we've got 2 eggs, 2 whole eggs goes in. 1 and 2. So we'll just give that, actually I might put the sugar in as well. Put that in. Probably about that much there, it'll be quite sufficient. I'll put a recipe up for you up here as per normal. So we'll just whisk that in like that. All right, slowly just get it all incorporated. And then we start adding the milk. Remember, buttermilk. All right. So just add a bit at a time here. Just carefully whisk it in, just like that. You'll see it gets nice and thick. Add some more milk. I always make a bloody mess, don't I? Oh, jeez. That's all right. It's all part of cooking. So give it a good old beat. You can use an electric beater if you want to, but I'm just showing you with my whisk in case you guys don't have one. So just give it a good old whisk up. Just like that. All right, now what we're going to do, we're nearly finished this part here. Like I said, it's quite easy. I'm just going to heat up the pan, get that going, so I can do my brown butter. And when you add brown butter to this, it is magic. So I do need some more flour in here. Okay, so I'm going to just go with that. We've still got a bit of milk in there. Now you can make this the day before, if you're going to have it, for a dessert the next day. You can make it a day early if you want. It's even better actually, because it gives the time to rest. All right, that's my mix here. Let's put it a little bit there. Actually, I probably need about 2.5 cups of flour. Might need a little bit more because I've still got. Because this is 600 mils, and I put 2 cups of flour. I think I need a bit more, it's a bit runny. Okay, so we'll go a bit more flour. And so just carefully whisk it, don't go too hard. All right, like I said, use an electric beater if you want to. So that's a nice mix now, but I've still got a little bit of this left. All right, that's that done. I will need a little bit more flour. You don't want it to be runny, yeah? So overall, I think I've probably used nearly 3 cups of flour here. So measure out 3 cups, and then if you need it all, use it all. Otherwise, just don't. All right. That's pretty good. I could go a little bit more, actually. You do want this to be thick, yeah? Remember, it's not, you're not making crepes, you're making pancakes. You want them nice and thick. All right, I'm going to add some vanilla extract in here. That's probably, about 4 teaspoons. Is good. That's looking damn good. All right. That's that. Done. Easy. I told you it was easy, didn't I? So the pan is over here hot now. Just going to throw the butter in. Now, brown butter becomes a very nutty, a nutty flavour, and gives it a beautiful flavour. Once you mix it in, and you, well, it's really yum. So you just let it go. See, it becomes, starts bubbling like that, and then it'll go kind of frothy. You just got to keep stirring it around, just move the pan around until it starts, you'll start to see it changing colour. All right, so it takes a couple of minutes for that to happen. See, it goes all frothy like that. See? So keep it going. Keep swinging it around, moving it around. It'll start to change colour in a minute after that frothiness goes away. So it's going to start very quickly in a minute. It changes very quickly, so you don't want to burn it. You just want it to be brown, okay? All right, there we go. So then you just drizzle this in and whisk at the same time, okay? Just be careful. It's got such a beautiful smell. Oh, that nuttiness is just beautiful. Unsalted butter too, by the way. So just whisk it in slowly. Okay, just like that. See, it's gone brown. That's what you want. It gives the pancakes such a beautiful flavour. Really nice. All right. Wake him back over there, because we're going to use that pan to make the actual pancakes in. So make sure you give it a good whisk, okay? Incorporate it all properly. All right, look at that. That is done. Very good. Yum, yum. All right. So now what you can do here, if you're going to make a few of them, what I would like you to do is make them, put them on a plate, and then just put some foil over the top to keep them warm while you make the banana mix. All right, so I'm just going to let that rest a little bit. So these things here I'm going to bring over here now to the stove, and I'll see you in a minute. I've just got to cut the bananas up. Okay, guys, I'm back here. I'm just going to cut the bananas. Don't get bananas that are too ripe. You want them to be, you know, a nice like that. Even a little bit green, it doesn't matter. Did you know that when apes eat bananas, they never break it from here. They always go from the bottom. We're the only stupid ones that do that. Don't know why. Everyone thinks it's a handle. So you take it from the bottom and just peel it all off like that. And that takes off all the, most of the stringy bits as well. I'm using 4 bananas here. So you can just do as much as you like, really. And don't cut them too small, because otherwise, though, when you cook them, they'll disappear. They'll just go to mush. And that you do not want. That's it. So what you want to do is cut them in a nice, chunky style, like just like that. And also, it depends how big the bananas are, because these aren't that big. yeah, so just nice, chunky pieces. Just cut it sideways like this. It's good. Okay. That's it. Put them into this bowl here. These are at a very nice stage of ripening. Alrighty, so what I'm now going to do is cook some pancakes. That's already heating up here nicely. And I've just put this pan on, so we're gonna do 2 things at once here. Get 2 things. This is very easy. This part of the banana sauce is so easy, it's a joke. So I'm just heating up this pan. Now what you do, just get your butter like that, or whichever way you want to do it, just swish it in there. By the way, I wiped that out before. Okay. And then we'll just put some beautiful mix in there, like so. Look at that. Yeah, beautiful. All right, just we'll just give it a bit of a tap like that. Just let that cook. Now, while that's doing that, okay, this is heating up here nicely. So I'm going to throw the butter in here. Get in there. Okay, so you put the butter and the sugar in together. So remember, this is four normal sized bananas. They weren't very big at all. So we'll just let that melt, and then we'll just throw the bananas in, toss it around a bit, get that sugar dissolved in there. See, that's cooking away as well. The way you tell when a pancake is ready to turn is when you see all these bubbles on top come up. All right, so don't have it too high because you don't want to burn the bum. So just medium heat will be good. You start it off hot, but then just turn it down. Okay, so the butter's melted. We can throw the bananas in here like so, just like that. And we just toss them around. Okay, you can stir around with a thing here, or you can just do what I just did. Toss it around if you can, if you want to, if you know how to do it. Then we just add some cream to it. That's it. That's pretty easy. Very, very easy. See, that's starting to get some bubbles. See? On there. I could probably toss it around. I could probably turn it. Yeah, I could turn it if I want to. Just like that. There we go. Beautiful. Just be careful when you flip it over, okay? So these are going nicely here. And I'll tell you what, something you could put into this for adults is some Malibu. Oh yeah, Malibu in this is crazy. Yum, yum, you could just put a nice splash in there. And then you light it to burn off the alcohol, so you just get the flavor. So now all I'm gonna do is just add some cream, just like that. Probably enough, actually. Well, maybe a little bit more. All right. Just let that cook away. Beautiful. This one here, let's just look at how nice and plump that is. Look at that. Look at that. Have a look at that. How gorgeous is that? Whee! Woo! Whee! Did a double one. Woohoo! Oh, what a pancake. I'm just going to put him in there. There's one. I'm going to do a double banger. Okay, so again, just like so. Get some more of this in there. Probably a couple of spoons, like this. If you haven't got a pan this size, don't worry. Just use whatever you got. If you got one that's too big, like this, you can even do it in this. It won't really matter. Okay, so that's going to, you just want to check your bananas, make sure they're not, yum. Make sure they're not getting too soft, okay? So just check them. So you're doing a couple of things here going on, and make sure that when you turn your pancake, that you see all the bubbles on top, all the air bubbles, and then flip it over, like I did. So that's boiling away nicely here. By the time the cream reduces down, the bananas will be way too soft. So what I might do, I might actually take out the bananas before that, and then just let the sauce come down. Okay, so my pancake has got the little bubbles there. It's not doing too bad. I might just take these bananas out now. Just put them in here. We don't want mushy bananas. Remember that, guys. All right, that's why we cut them nice and thick like this. Pancake is ready to turn around again. So you just turn it around like whoop, and then flip him over. Okay, and it doesn't take long on the other side because it's already just about cooked anyway, through. and that is going beautifully. The bananas look good. You can add walnuts in this as well, if you really wanted to. Bananas and walnuts go well. But today I'm just doing bananas, just to quickly show. You can do any kind of sauce you want, whatever tickles your fancy. Doesn't it just have to be bananas? You can make an apple mix, you can make a berry mix, you can do anything. So don't forget to take out the bananas so they don't go mushy, okay? Let that reduce down until it goes thickish. You'll see it go down. And Bob's your uncle, and Mary's your auntie. See how that's doing that now? Starting to go down, starting to get thicker. See that? Too watery at the moment, but it'll go down, don't worry. It'll reduce nice. You can actually, with the walnuts, you don't have to put them in the mix here because they go a little bit soft, but you can just get them and put them on top afterwards. So I put in about, I reckon, half a litre of cream in here. So just remember, it depends how many people you're cooking for is the amount that you want. So let's just add your bananas in there. And there we go, look at that. Okay. Well, basically you're just heating up the bananas in here, really. All right, that is done, guys. So all we need to do now is basically serve it up and eat it. All right, so all we're doing now is serving it up. So nice, look at that. Yeah, ha ha ha. And you know what the best part is? If you go to the pancake parlor or something like that, they only put so much amount on. You can put as much as you want. Look at that. Look at that. Yum, yum. You gotta have ice cream with this. You can't not have it. You can't not. And there we go. Look at that. Hey, how delicious does that look? That's sick. Sick, sick, sick. And the best part is now I gotta try it out for you. This. Yum, yum, yum. Move that out of the road. Get you a couple of banana slices on there. Oh, they're so fluffy. Oh my God, look at that. Oh, look at that, guys. Ooh. Oh, I'm dripping, but doesn't matter. I want to show you. Look at that. Mate, you don't need to go to Pancake Parlor when you got stuff like this at home. This is just freaking mad. Absolutely mad. Got to go again. Sorry, guys. Got to try it again. Just to make sure, you know. I wasn't pretending. Ah, oh, bloody yuck, it's fallen off. That is sick. So you can serve probably two or three people with this. And if you see that you don't have enough sauce, just add a bit more cream to it. And that's it. But like I said, adult's version, add Malibu to it. When you're cooking, before you put the cream, add the Malibu, toss it around, light it to light the alcohol off it, and then when the flame goes out, then add your cream. And let me tell you, with the Malibu, it is really crazy, crazy good. Anyway, guys, well, that's another one. So hopefully I'll be able to put something else very soon. Yeah, so if you've liked this, smash that like button, give us a good old thumbs up, share me around to your friends and family or whoever you want to, and I will see you all at the next adventure. Until then, happy cooking to everyone. Ciao.